So when we're asked to find a greatest common factor or a lowest least common multiple of a number, a pair of numbers, the easiest way to do that is to factor it down to its prime numbers. A prime number is a number that's only divisible by one and itself. The smallest prime number is 2. If I'm looking at 18, 18 is divisible by 9 and 2. But 9 is divisible by 3 and 3. So if I was looking at the prime factorization, this would be 3 times 3 times 2. This is the bottom part of my factor tree. We could also think of this as being 3 squared times 2. Everybody okay with the factor tree? We're going to come over and do the same thing with 27. 27 would be the same as 9 times 3, but 9 can be represented by 3 times 3. So again, the bottom of my factor tree is here, 3 times 3 times 3, or we could look at this as being 3 cubed. Buddy, okay? Understand what we did? Okay. When you're finding the greatest common factor, you look for the greatest that's in both. So if I look, I see there's a 3 here and there's a 3 here. I can take that 3 out. I see there's a 3 here and that there's a 3 here, and I can take that 3 out. Or I can look here and say, what is the greatest number I can take out of both of them, since it's a factor? I can take out 3 to which power? The second power. 3 times 3 is 9. In other words, the greatest number that will go into both 18 and 27 is what? 9. In order to take it out for a greatest common factor, it must show up in both of the numbers. Notice I didn't take out this 2, because there wasn't a 2 in 27. I didn't take out the additional 3, because there wasn't another 3 to take out in 18. Everybody okay with the greatest common factor? Least common multiple is almost the opposite of that. It says, if it shows up in one of them or the other, you have to use it. So you've got to take out the biggest one that's there. Not the biggest one that's in both, but the biggest one that is there at all. If it shows up once, you've got to use it. Well, again, if I went right up to the beginning, there's a 3 here, there's a 3 here. There's a 3 here, there's a 3 here. But there's an additional 3. Right? And there's an additional what? 2. Notice that what we ended up taking out was the 3 cubed, the largest exponent, because I've got to take them all out. And then we also took out the 2. Well, what I'm doing is now is I'm taking 27 times 2, which is 54. So the least common multiple, in other words, the smallest number, the lowest number that either of these would go into, is 54. Well, which of these two then would make my better lowest common denominator? Do I want to use the greatest common factor or the least common multiple? This 54 and the lowest common denominator, if these were my denominators, would be the same. When you're finding the least common denominator, what you're asking yourself is, what is the least common multiple of those two numbers? Everybody remember doing this? It's been a long time probably since you've done it, because we didn't do it in our class, have we? So this is a fifth or sixth grade type thing. So it's been a while since you've done it. Everybody remember seeing it though? Okay. Now, I want you to look at number one. And there's lots of different ways that you can approach when you've got three numbers that are there. First off, if I saw a number and I knew I could simplify it, like this one and this one, I probably would. 7/8 can't be simplified. But 2/4 could be. What could I write it as? 1/2. What could I write 14/16 as? 7/8. If I used order of operations the way it's intended, I would then have to put 7/8 together with 1/2, wouldn't I? Is that the best way to put these together? No, really, I'd be better off putting these two together because they already have what? They already have a common denominator. What property allows me to change the order like that? Somebody else want to try? The commutative property allows me to commute. Associative property keeps the order the same, but the grouping changes. Okay? Well, what is 7/8 plus 7/8? 14/8 plus 1/2. Again, if I could simplify something, I probably would. What does this 14/8 simplify to? 7 over 4. What would I have to do at this point? Which is going to be what? 4. Obviously, this first one doesn't change. But if I had to multiply the denominator by 2, I've got to multiply the numerator also by 2. This would be 2 over 4, and this would become 9/4. And if I write that as a mixed number, this would become 2 and 1/4. I want you to change these today, all of them, if they will change to what? I want to ch change them to a mixed number. Everybody okay with number one? I want you to flip it over to the other side because we're going to change the back side a little bit. Because we're working with addition and subtraction, whatever the middle number is, all the way down, we're going to change that. Instead of addition, we're going to make it what? Subtraction. So take that first one and make it 3/5 minus 1/6 plus 2/6. And all the way down, we're going to change that second number, or that middle number, to what? Subtraction, or a negative versus being a positive. Now, on this problem, once I've made this change, if I was working order of operations, what should I do first? Well, if I was using order of operations, what should I do? I should do these two. But I really don't want to do those two, do I? What I'd really like to do is this. Right? Which property allows me to do that? This one's the associative property. The order stayed the same, but the grouping changed. So we're going to use the associative property to make it so that we can put the two of them that have the same denominator together first. Well, what is 2/6 take away 1/6? 1/6. So I have 3/5 plus 1/6. What's my denominator going to end up being this time? It's going to end up being 30, which means both of them have to change. I had to multiply the first one by a 6 in the denominator, so I do that also in the numerator. And this one I had to multiply by 5. And 18 plus 5 is 23. Make sure that your answer won't simplify, even if it won't change to a mixed number, make sure it's in the simplest form. And 23 over 30 won't simplify, it won't reduce, and that would be my answer. What's that? Everybody good? On the front side, you're going to do straight addition. On the back side, where that middle number says to add, you are going to subtract that middle number.
Did you subtract
the answer? I did. Because 2 6 minus 1 6 is what? 1 6.
With number 12.
Mm-hmm.
Like those two are already at 4, but that's at 44, and you would have to divide it by 12, I mean 11 to get 4, but you can't divide 7 by 11.
You can multiply it. You got to go the other way. You got to get the lowest common denominator, not the greatest common factor. Okay? Okay. Listen, I was asked if I could go back, but I want to tell you what we're going to do. The first three people that can bring me their worksheet complete and correct, I'm going to give 10 extra credit points. Anybody that can finish it before the end of class with 80% correct, in other words, no more than 4 missed, I'm going to give 5 extra credit points. But in order to do this, you have to work what? Alone. But I get it? The first three people that can bring me it up where they're all correct are going to get 10 extra credit points. Anybody that can finish it before class that has 80% correct or better is going to get 5 extra credit points. You're still going to get credit for working on the worksheet. But I got it? And Dylan, now I've went back. Okay, so that you can see it. All right?